All right, so today we are doing the Mongols. We are going to continue our week 10 notes Monday. Now, ladies and gentlemen, I am stressing this. Now, you've been ignoring me for 10 weeks, some of you, so, you know, why would you start now? But, ladies and gentlemen, if you do not work on your focus and pieces this weekend, you are going to get run over. Because on Tuesday, you're going home with a four short answers and one long essay question, which are due on Thursday. So if your plan is to wait to the very end to do your focus and pieces, like I know most of you do, I've seen them, that is a horrific idea. Can we agree? So keep in mind, this week is ending pre-test into essays. So like, if you do not plan accordingly and spend your time this weekend working, you're gonna kind of die inside. Or outside, too. Like, you could look like this, but you would not have made a lot of money. You would have just been working on focus or pieces, so that's sad for you. With that being said, your end of your week is going right into writing week. So, if you die the night of the test, right before the test, trying to do your focus and pieces, you're going to have a super, super, super long week. Can we agree? So, I'm warning you now. Get as much as your focus and your pieces done over this weekend, and you'll have time to breathe throughout the week. If you're gonna listen to me once, it probably should be this weekend. But do you? Because the grades are still due on Friday when the test is. Is everyone clear? So I'm trying to help you out. Plan accordingly. You'll be happier long term because you have 5 essays coming in before your test. 5. That's a lot of essays. So I would get your focus and pieces done ahead of time so your quality of life doesn't suck. Okay? So, Monday, friendly reminder, you have vocab 11 through 20 in week 10. Slav war in week 10, boss. So, we're doing primary source on Monday. Tuesday, you have 21 through 30, or it's 28 or something. It only goes to 28, so we'll test to 28. On Wednesday, we have no class. You'll be writing essays without me. Okay? The faster we get through content this week means I can help you plan on Tuesday when I see you. So, the goal today is move as quick as we can. I'm going to try to keep my amazing stories to a minimum because I love the Mongols. So I will try to move as quick as we can because the faster we move, the better your life quality of life is at the end of the week. Heed my warning. Work on your focus and your pieces this weekend or you will die and then you roll right into writing week, which you know you're going to die in anyway. Can we agree? So do your job, get it done ahead of time, and your quality of life will be better. If you listen to me once, make it this week. Okay, on your whiteboard. We have a little bit, let's do it. On your whiteboard, please tell me, what part of Asia are the Mongols from? Where are they from, Kevin? Not Kevin, I haven't really done that, Brian. I'm so sorry. Kevin is his brother. Brian, what do you got? Central. I'm so sorry, I think that's like the second time I've done it. I'm so sorry. On your whiteboard, please tell me, what is the name of, what type of government style are the traditional Mongols? What type of government style are the traditional Mongols? Good, I got 1, 2, 3, 4. What is it, Maggie?
Land-based.
Land-based, or kinship would work too, that would also score. On your whiteboard, please tell me, they are going to use in their military, every man has a what, which will make them incredibly fast, which will make them dominant. Joey?
Horses.
Or cavalry. On your whiteboard, please tell me, what is the name of the gentleman who is going to unify the Khans? What is the name of the guy? I need both spellings. Because I need to know that you know that there are two spellings. Good. Where are they, Lily? Yeah. Perfect. On your whiteboard, please tell me, what is the trade of your Mongols, your traditional Mongols? What is the trade?
Oh, shit, I just told you. Huh? They trade. That's what they do.
On your whiteboard, please tell me, what is their traditional religion? Good. Evan? Paganism. On your whiteboard, some convert to what religion? Good. Daniel?
Islam.
Islam. Who can raise their hand and tell me why that makes logical sense? Makes complete logical sense. Cade. Well, that's a lackluster answer, friend. Why?
They use trade. I don't know.
Sterling.
Well, because that was like the, since they were training a lot, they had to deal with people like so many trades.
Islam's not a language.
There's
a mutual culture? How's that? Okay, because you said language, and I don't want you to think it's a language. Okay, perfect. Take out your notes. Let's go. All right. Who can raise your hand? Let me know where we left off. What do you got, Evelyn? Perfect. Oh, so we haven't even gone to Genghis, have we?
No, we just did Mongol's population as well.
Oh, okay. So then we're doing okay.
Where
is Genghis? Okay, so you need to know that Genghis Khan.
Stop it.
I'm already struggling, okay? Jared has already made that clear. You need to know that his military has cavalry, which we've already kind of talked about, but they also have short bows, which you absolutely is a new thing. Short bows. So, like, all of you have seen, like, Robin Hood. Hello, look at me. Robin Hood is when he stands here and pulls it all the way back and then shoots, like the Mockingjay. She does a full bow. A short bow is like this. So, what's the difference?
Fast.
Super fast, and that's what the short bows are. They're super fast. Apparently, a good Mongol rider, not a great one, can shoot 100 arrows a minute on a horse going full tilt. Yeah. That is, like, insane. That's how fast they could go, and that's why they're so effective. Keep in mind, are they a huge population or a small population?
Small.
So if they're a small population, how big is their military?
Awesome.
Not that big, but their brutality, their quickness of the horses, as well as their skills on the short bow, is really why they're going to be successful. So please keep that in mind. You also need to know that they reward enemies who surrender and cruel to enemies who fight. Why would they do this? We kind of talked about it yesterday while doing the map. Why, Daniel?
So more people are like, what's it called? They want them to surrender so they can capture more territory faster.
Yeah, absolutely. Would you rather fight or would you rather just have people give you things? Give you things, and that's exactly what they do. So if they have the reputation, and believe me, they earned it, okay? They'll happily kill everyone in town, but it's just easier for them if you just turn everything over. Do you think this is an easy reputation to build, or do you think it takes a lot of cities to destroy? Quite a few is right, okay? So, you need to know that the Mongols are gonna conquer all of China in less than 10 years. Now keep in mind, where is the wealthiest place in the world right now?
China.
So do you think they can pay a pretty big military? Yeah, guess who beats them? A bunch of Mongols. A bunch of people who live in the desert, who can barely farm and don't know how to run a government. They beat China. That's why the Mongols are so fascinating. Okay? You need to know that they are going to do, when they conquer a territory, they do large-scale, long-term devastation. You need to know that. When they take over a territory, it's not like they're just trying, like, for instance, if China came to the United States today and tried to take over the United States, do you think China would come in and destroy our natural resources? No. Do you think they would kill a lot of people or just as minimal amount of people? Probably minimal, right? Because they are going to come in and rule and they don't want to be seen as, like, you know, completely brutal. What do you think about the Mongols? They don't care. They are literally will do whatever it takes to kill you. For instance, the Black Plague is starting in China, and when they take over China first, they are going to cut heads off of people who have died of bubonic plague. They're going to put them on a wagon, drive to the city that's fighting them, and then they're going to chuck the heads over the wall. The reason why, these are the Mongols, they're amazing. The reason why they throw the heads over the wall is because they're still infected. So if you touch the heads, guess what you get? Black Plague. So what happens inside this perfectly good city? The Black Plague is going to kill a third of the population. This is how they fight. They don't care about preservation. They don't care about natural resources because are the Mongols used to natural resources? No, they live off the land and they take what they can and they're used to living in tough conditions. So they don't give a shit. They are going to do whatever it takes to kill as many people as possible to take the city as effectively as possible. You need to understand that, because they are going to destroy entire regions, like Russia, for instance. Russia will not make full capacity until about 200 years after the Mongols leave. Okay? So it's a big deal. Evelyn. When they conquer territory, they do large scale, long-term devastation. Okay? So they're not in there to, like, benefit from the land. They're in there to kill. And they're effective. Okay? They're going to do whatever it takes. Okay. Skip a space. Center it. You need to write down Yaun Dynasty. Y-A-U-N. Okay? Yuan Dynasty. Next to that, you're going to write Mongols. That's the name of the Chinese dynasty when the Mongols are in control. Okay? So, it goes Xia, Shang, Zhao, Qin, Han, Sui, Tang, Song, Yan. Okay? It's not confusing, but maybe we'll have this down. Okay? So, yeah. You should have it on the back of your notes. So, it should be Sui, Tang, Song. Dang Song should be your next one, and then Yang. That's your next.
You haven't written anything after the Han?
Han.
Sweet
Dang
Song.
Song.
And then
Yang. Here we go. So, under the Yan Dynasty, which is Mongol China, which is what I'd also write on the heading, Mongol China, you need to know the major ruler is Kublai Khan. Now, who is going to conquer Mongol China? Who conquers it? Emma. Genghis Khan conquers it, but Kublai Khan is going to be the first major ruler of it. Do you think Genghis Khan, who's like super effective at killing people, is really going to rule things, or does he just like killing people? Yeah, he just really likes killing people. Kublai Khan is going to be your first world ruler in China. Kublai Khan is an absolute must-know. You need to know he rules China. You need to know that he is ruthless, just like your boy Genghis. However, he is religiously tolerant. Who can raise their hand and explain to me why the Mongols are religiously tolerant? They're all religiously tolerant, Maggie?
Some of them are pagan and some of them are Islam.
Absolutely. Yes, they already have a mix in their traditional culture. So do you think they're really going to care? Do you think Mongols really care what you do in your houses?
No.
No. As long as you're doing what you're supposed to do, that's what they care about. Now, you do need to know that they are going, he is going to attempt to expand his empire and fails. He attempts to expand his empire and fails. I don't need you to know Vietnam, Cambodia, Burma. I don't care if you know that. However, you do need to know that he attempts 2 invasions of Japan and fails. Now, what makes Japan tricky to conquer? You can raise your hand, Tom. What makes it tricky? Sure.
It's an island.
So what do you have to do if you're going to an island? You have to take a boat. Ladies and gentlemen, why would Mongols have a problem with boats? It makes logical sense. Why would they have a problem with boats? Why?
They're horse
people. They're from the middle of Asia. Ladies and gentlemen, how many oceans are in the middle of Asia? The answer is 0. Because it's the largest landmass in the world. There's no ocean. So do you think your Mongols are good seafaring people?
No.
No. You need to know that the Japanese are protected by 2 typhoons. Typhoons are hurricanes in the Pacific. They call this divine winds or kamikazes. Now, ladies and gentlemen, when are we going to hear kamikazes again?
World War II.
They consider the United States as big of a threat as the Mongols were. So they call themselves kamikazes in order to defend the island. How'd it go round 2? Not well. We won. However, that's why they call them kamikazes. So they are going, isn't that kind of crazy though? The Mongols are literally going to get in boats, and obviously they're terrible at boats. And then while they're in their boats, 2 hurricanes come through and kill off most of them. That's kind of strange. Can we agree?
Yeah.
The 2 attacks and there's a hurricane, it's pretty crazy. So you do need to know that, by the way. Okay. Now, skip a space, center it. The Golden Horde. Next to that, I would write Mongol Russia. Oh, you need to know Marco Polo is in Kublai Khan's China.
We're going to come back to Marco Polo, but you need to know Marco Polo is hanging out with Kublai Khan in Mongol China. Sorry. I got so excited about the Japanese things. Okay. Golden Horde. Okay. You need to know it will be the longest held Mongol territory. You need to know this is the closest they get to Russia, to Europe. And they're going to terrorize Poland, Hungary, and Germany. What do you got?
Why did they, what was the name
of the they just got too big. Golden Horde is not very organized. Like, they're not very effectively run. There's only a couple really good Mongol leaders, and none of them are in Russia. So they're not very organized and they're not very good. And then Russia's so big, the Golden Horde is so big, they just can't manage their country. So they just go in and like steal shit and just like leave. They just can't maintain. And that's like the problem with the Mongols and the Russia. Okay. What do you got?
Did you say
it right next to the Mongol Russia. Okay, so the Golden Horde, you just need to know they're gonna terrorize Europe, but they're not gonna hold anything in Europe except obviously Russia. Okay. Give a space, center it. Ikhanate of Persia, which is Mongol Persia. You need to know they're going to defeat the Abbasid Empire. They're the ones who are going to knock them off the map. And keep in mind, they've been around for a long time. They've also been very successful. Okay, so keep in mind. So these Mongols are fierce. Right? They're killing everybody. Okay? So, you need to know that they're going to sack Baghdad. Baghdad is going to be one of the cities that fight the hardest against the Mongols. I have to tell you the story. I shouldn't, but I am. It's getting puzzled. So, in Baghdad, what they do is, in the center of Baghdad, they have, like, this massive square, which is where they host all the things. It's where you had, like, the big bazaars where people would go every week to go shopping and stuff like that. It's a major trading capital of the Middle East. It's the largest city. It's the most important city for trade for the Muslims. So what they do is they force everyone into the center of the square, 200,000 people, and the Mongols are on the outside, and all the people are in the center. They cut their throats from the outside to the inside. It took them over 4 hours. That's a long... Imagine being the dude in the middle!
Right? Like,
and guys, when you cut someone's throat, their parts are still pumping, so it squirts the blood. Apparently, they were up to their calves in blood. Why did they do it? Touche, Evan. Why not? Why did they do it? Keep in mind, Baghdad is the biggest city. And they put up the hardest fight. Why'd they do it, Shannon? To make an example. If you heard the biggest, the most protected city fell to the Mongols, and then they collected everyone. I'm talking men, women, and children. One by one, the Mongols cut their throats in the center. If you're just a small trading town on the outskirts of Baghdad, what are you going to do? I surrender. Absolutely. And that's what's going to cause the collapse of the rest of the Middle East. As soon as they capture Baghdad, everyone's like, holy shit, these people are crazy. Don't you love them? Because I do. They're terrible people. Can we agree? But amazing, horrible people. What do you got?
So if the Mongols like started off as like a small like group of people,
yeah,
they didn't have a government, why did
they had a government. It's just clan-based government. Okay, it's just not a centralized government.
Okay, so why did they like want to conquer so many like big places?
Because they're awesomely horrible people. They hated the Chinese, which we're going to get to here in a second, and the Chinese have always made their life hell, so they were like, screw you, China. And so they're just going to like totally like just shit on China and just do terrible things to China. And that's why Mongolia today is absolutely harassed by China on a regular basis. Chinese are still getting it back from the Mongols. Moving forward. So, Mongol rule in Persia. You do need to know the Mongols have no idea how to rule such a large territory. Why? What is their traditional government? Clan. Can you rule Asia with a clan? No. It is way too big. These Mongols are really good at killing people, but they have no idea how to do anything else.
So when they get to Persia, they really like the government structure, their bureaucracy. You need to write that down. They really like the Persian bureaucracy. Okay? So what they're going to do is that they are going to take Persian bureaucrats and spread them throughout all Mongol empires. So they're like, oh, I like this. This makes sense. I'm going to steal Persians and go to bring them to China, for instance, and say, make government. And then the Persians are like, well, what the hell? We don't want to speak their language. And they're like, government. And they're like, what? And they're like, death or government. And they're like, oh, shit, I'll make a government. And that's exactly what they do. They don't know how to do anything. Now, the biggest impact, the biggest reason why they implement the Persians is because they lose tons of money on tax revenue. Need to write that down. Do you think the Mongols pay taxes in traditional Mongol?
No.
No. However, what is the easiest way for a government to make money?
Taxes.
And so with this large empire, they want people to start paying taxes to them because it will fuel the Mongol Empire, correct? So they don't know how to collect taxes. So they use the Persians to collect taxes, which is really why they're implementing. Do you think they want to make people's lives better?
No.
The only reason they implement Persian government is because they want the Persians to collect money for them because they don't know how to do it. They don't know how to set taxes. They don't know how to collect money. You need to know that. You also need to write down, they like Persian culture the best. So they're going to take the Persian government structure and their culture the most. Okay. Now, our next heading is you're going to write China, or Yuan Dynasty, whatever you want. Yuan Dynasty, you need to know Mongol China is Yuan Dynasty.
Are the Hans and the Mongols similar?
No. The Han are Chinese. They're their own people. The Mongols hate the Chinese. Like, for instance, you need to know the Chinese were considered second-class citizens in China. You need to write that down. Like, that's a big deal. You need to know that you are not allowed to marry, if you're a Mongol, you can't marry a Chinese person. And if you're Chinese, you're not allowed to speak Mongolian. By the way, they're in China. That's amazing. Okay? So, you need to know that they kick all Chinese out of Chinese government. If you're Chinese, you cannot work for the government in China. And they replace them with Persians. Do you think they have a problem with the Chinese?
No.
Yeah, you're right. They hate the Chinese. Just because the Chinese made their lives hell for like 1,000 years with all the trading and stuff, they treated them like shit. The Mongols are like, yeah, the peace is lost now. Okay. You need to know that they are going to, under the Mongols, Buddhism is going to flourish. Under the Mongols, Buddhism is going to flourish. Why? It makes logical sense. What is Buddhism all about? I taught this to you. What are the rules of Buddhism? Let's start there. Shannon.
It's like very nature-based.
Nah, it's not really nature-based. What do you got?
Like, it's about peace.
Yeah. What are the rules? What are the rules called? Eightfold Path, which is part of the Four Noble Truths. The Four Noble Truths is life is suffering.
Oh.
Why do you think Buddhism became popular in China under the Mongols? Because they're suffering, and you need to acknowledge that. Buddhism becomes very popular in China under the Mongols because the Chinese are suffering under their rule, and Buddhism is escape from suffering. That's why it grows so popular in China, because they're miserable. Why are they miserable? Because the Mongols are, A, just killing them indiscriminately. Like, if you're a Mongol and you just kill 15 Chinese people while you're walking to work that day, it's just a day. Okay? So, they literally don't care, so you do need to know that, okay? You need to know that the Mongols are also going to start embracing Buddhism as well. Mongols are also going to start
embracing Buddhism.
Keep in mind, ladies and gentlemen, does the Mongols have a strong culture? Really? So they morph into wherever they are. Remember, they really like Persian culture. They've already adopted Islam prior to this. So as they're exposed to things, they kind of adopt. They're very much so, like, utilitarian. They're just kind of including things and evolving. So you are going to get some Mongols who are going to start doing this. So much so that there is a Genghis Khan Buddha. Who is the opposite of Buddha? Genghis Khan, which is ironic and funny all the same. You don't need to write that down, but you just need to know the Mongols are going to pick up Buddhism because they pick up things as they go because of the Mongols. What do you got?
Do they make any statues of them?
Yeah. You can probably, like, buy one online. Not like the original. It's obviously going to be replicated. But yeah, you can buy a Genghis Khan Buddha, which is just, like, the biggest oxymoron in the history of the world. Yeah, you need to skip a space and center it. Impact of Mongols on the West. When I say West, who are we talking about?
Europe.
Okay? You need to know the Mongols are going to increase trade along the Silk Road. Why? There's two major reasons why. Who can tell me what is one major reason the Mongols are going to increase trade on the Silk Road? Evelyn. Okay, they kind of like money. Don't write that down. They love money. Why? Because they've never had it before. Have you ever seen someone make money for the first time? Oh, for instance, I'm a poor person. How excited I am that I made a lot of money last night.
Yes.
I literally announced it to you that I made a lot of money last night, and I'm very excited about it. So imagine me, times like 1,000, because the Mongols were even poorer than me, making money. So they're very excited about money, so they're happy to make money. Fine. Why? What logical madness behind the Mongols? Why? There you go. They're going to streamline the tariffs. To go on the Silk Road, how many tariffs do you have to pay? One for the Mongols. That's it. Beforehand, you had to pay like 30. Okay, if you only have to stop once to pay a tariff, does that make it faster or slower? Faster. You also need to know they are going to implement a police force on the Silk Road. Actually, there's three reasons. Okay, they're going to implement a police force. Why would that make trade faster? Come on, you think with me. Daniel.
It protects the traders.
Yes, it protects the traders. And if you didn't have to worry at night as you're driving your little caravan that you're going to get mugged by like some raider, okay, you're able to go faster and you're able to go further. The third reason is they create pony expresses. Okay, so obviously today that you, like, when you go on a road trip, you pull into the gas station and they have like a Starbucks, they have like a Subway, and they have all these like refueling stations. As you're pumping your car, you can get like anything you want to eat. Okay, it's essentially that. However, it's all filled with horses, so you come in with exhausted horses from running like 200 miles, you drop your horses off, and they give you 10 new horses. So, is that slow you down or increase your speed? Increase your speed. So, you do need to know. They have pony expresses, which means you come in, you drop off your tired ponies, and you get new ponies. And then those ponies are like, yeah, we're going on a road trip. And they're like, yeah, go. What do you got?
What was the first reason you said?
First reason is they have one tariff with the Mongols. Okay. You do need to know. Okay, so those are your three major reasons why trade increases. You need to know that because the Mongols are freedom of religion, you have more people, you have more missionaries on the Silk Road. AP loves that crap. Okay, so you have more missionaries on the Silk Road because they're so pro, like, religious freedom. The Mongols only care about money. They don't care what you do as long as you don't objectify their rule. Okay. Skip a space, center it. Oh, why don't you put it, actually, before you do that, put a big star, because this is going to come back later as we describe. You need to know that they, because the Mongols unified the Silk Road, the bubonic plague is going to spread faster. Why does it spread faster? Because the Mongols unified the Silk Road. Come on, people. Come on, Reagan.
There's more people traveling, and also it's continuous.
And it's going what now?
It's
going faster. There's more people doing it. We're moving faster, and
you know, it's a streamlined process, okay? So, the Mongols are going to do great things for the Silk Road. The whole world benefits from them. They also just do atrocious things. Skip a space, center it. Decline of Persian, decline of the Iconid of Persia. You need to know, the Mongols don't manage money well. Who can raise their hand and tell me why the Mongols don't manage money well? Why? Ryan? Yeah, well, they're violent, yes, but, like, what's their big problem, Evelyn? They don't know how to run a government. So do you think they automatically figured it out? No. As long as they have money coming in, they're like, cool, we can spend as much as we want. Is that how you run a government? No. Okay? So they are going to overspend, and they're going to overspend, and they're going to do poor tax collection. What does that mean, to do poor tax collection? No. That would be great. Emma?
They, like,
yeah. People, like, don't pay taxes. And do you think the Mongols are organized enough to know who it is? No. They have no idea. So do you think everyone is paying their full share? No, because they're like, these idiots don't know what they're doing. Do you think people in the United States would pay the U.S. government full their full tax requirement if they think they could get away with it? No. However, the IRS is 2 years behind, okay? They're 2 years behind. They're currently checking 2016 IRS thing. So if you lied on 2016, they're coming after you. They're 2 years behind, but they're coming, okay? It's an efficient system, and they will get their money, okay? Mongols? Nah. They're idiots. So, they can't manage their money. Okay, you need to understand. They are going to replace money with gold, paper money with gold. Because remember, the Persians go from gold to paper money, and then the Mongols are like, no, I want gold. Can you really go from paper money to gold? No, it is not good. It is going to cause massive inflation. Okay, causes massive inflation. Okay, causes massive inflation and destabilizes their economy. It's like if tomorrow Donald Trump announced that he is going to change our currency to the Trump buck. Okay? Would that be a good thing for our economy or a terrible thing?
Terrible.
Same thing that's happening here is going to destabilize our economy. Okay? You need to know that you're going to, that's good enough. Skip a space. Decline of the yawn. Okay, you need to know that they're going to spend all the gold that is used to support their paper currency. Now, ladies and gentlemen, we have paper currency. If you have a $20 bill in your pocket, that essentially represents $20 worth of gold, correct? Our gold here in the United States is held, a majority of it. There's multiple locations, but we all happen to know Fort Knox. Have you ever heard it's the safest Fort Knox? Okay? Like, there's pictures, not a ton of pictures, but you can just see gold block after gold block, like, columns of, like, 10 feet tall of just gold bricks, like, billions of dollars of gold are sitting at Fort Knox. Okay? There's also other locations throughout the United States, which makes sense they wouldn't tell us where they are. Can we agree? Anyway, all of that backs our currency. So, essentially, what that means, now in 2019, things are a little bit different than back then. Can we agree? Times are more complicated, we have more people. But if you go to the bank today, and I would take a $100 bill, because 20 bucks is going to get you, like, a shaving of gold. If you take 100 bucks and go to the bank and say, I want gold, that's essentially what your currency kind of represents. You have $100, it's worth $100 worth of gold. Does that make sense? So if you don't have gold to back up every single paper bill you have, what is the value of your paper? Like, the paper you're writing on is as worth as much as a paper currency if it doesn't have gold to support it. Okay? Do you think the Mongols understand? No. So when they took over China and the Chinese had, like, a Fort Knox full of gold to back their paper currency, what do you think they did with it? Yeah, because they don't understand how the economy works. They don't understand what they're doing. So what they did is they completely destabilized China's economy. Write that down. They spend all the bullion. Bullion is what we call money that keeps our currency viable. Like a $100 bill makes $100 worth of gold. They destabilized this economy. Why is that shockingly horrifying? They destabilized China's economy. Why is that horrifying and tells you how much of idiots they are? Why, Lily?
Because they're the richest place in the world.
They're the richest place in the world with the strongest economy the world's ever seen, including today. And they destabilized it, which means it started losing money. Like, you should be horrified by how bad these people are at business, okay? With that being said, inflation rises, prices rise. Now, if prices go up and inflation goes up, how's that country doing? Not good. It's absolutely terrible. And because of the Mongols, China will never become as successful as it's ever been. That's how bad these people are. China will never be as prosperous until, you could say, today in 2019. China will not recover historically until about 2005, 2010, when they start recovering and becoming a major powerhouse like they are today. It will take to present-day China to get back on top. Keep in mind, they're still the major destination of worldwide trade. But the Mongols spend so much of their bullion and all these other things to destabilize their economy so much because of how bad they manage that China will not recover until the 2000s. We're in 1200. That's insane. You need to understand like the huge, big part of that. So you also need to know the bubonic plague starts in China. Okay, the bubonic plague starts in China. They have almost a 50% death rate in China. In Europe, it's about 30%. Okay? So, China is losing money for the first time in its history. Okay? They're literally losing money. And you have a 50% death rate in China. I think we can all see this is the end of the Mongols in China. Can we agree? So, you do need to know them. Peasants are going to rebel. They're incredibly weak because of the bubonic plague. Everyone hates the Mongols, and they'll eventually fall. Okay, so a peasant revolt will be the final break, and China will fall. Okay. So, skip a space, center it. There is only two places where the Mongol will rule. The Ikhanate of Chinggadi, which is their home Mongolia. And the Golden Horde, you need to know that. They're going to continue on for a long time. There's only two places the Mongols are going to continue to be successful, and it is in the Ikhanate of Chinggadi and the Golden Horde, and they're going to continue for another, like, they continue into the 1600s. Guys, the United States colonies have already, like, they're like, real colonies at this point. Like, we have people, like, living in the United States. We have slaves, for God's sakes, in the United States, and the Mongols are still ruling Russia. That's insane. That's crazy. All right. Skip a space, center it. Tamerlane. Okay. You need to know he is Turkish. And he is going to build the major Mongolian capital of Samarkand. Samarkand is going to be the major capital of the Mongols. That's their major trading city. That is their major capital city, and it's located in Chinggadi, by the way. Which makes sense, because Chinggadi is their home Mongolia. Samarkand. Okay, so he's going to make the major capital there. Okay. It's incredibly disorganized. Why is it incredibly disorganized? It's what? They're Mongols. They don't know what they're doing. All right, so it's incredibly disorganized. However, it's incredibly disorganized, so there's no heir. Okay, so it collapses after Tamerlane. However, it's incredibly influential to the Mughal, the Safavid, and the Ottomans.
Can someone get the door? I think this is too much. It's Bennett. Absolutely.
No problem.
Thanks for sending
me
out. Thank you, Sam.
Sorry, the phone was ringing and we were not getting the door. There's just a lot going on. Okay, so you need to know because in 2 weeks we're dealing with the Mughal, the Safavid, and the Ottomans, who are all influenced by Tamerlane. That's really all you need to know. I don't know if I care about Ottomans right now because we'll cover it. Perfect. Skip a space, center it. The faster we go, lady. Oh, we gotta do boards. Let's do boards. Here we go. On your whiteboard, please tell me, what do we call Mongol Russia? What do we call Mongol Russia? Guys, we're in a good spot because I'm trying to hustle to get us so we can be in a good spot for Tuesday. What is it, Evelyn?
Golden Horde.
Golden Horde. What do we call Mongol Persia? Katie, what did you think was gonna happen? You were gonna wait for you? Okay. Oh, yeah, it's going to be boss. What do we got, Ashlyn? And would you tell Katie that today's class was actually entertaining? Yeah, we killed millions of people today. We slit 200,000 throats. I know, man. It was wild. Okay. In Baghdad, of course. So, you know. On your whiteboard, please tell me, what do we call where the Mongols are absolutely terrible at tax collection and what other thing? What is that?
I thought you asked where.
No. Good. What is it, Reagan? Government. Government. They're absolutely terrible. Because they're terrible at tax collection and how to run a government, they import who from where? What is it? Jared. Persians from where? I can hit a Persia. It would be better, but yes. All right. Have a good day. So do we like the Mongols? They're awesome. And there are so many things I didn't get to tell you. Because I really was trying to hustle hard. Like the way they kill people, like after they capture, while they're sitting there eating their lunch, they just have, they sharpen a tree to come to a point, and then they put a person at the top, and then they bet who's going to be the fast first one to come to the bottom of the tree. Yeah. Oh, are you ready to go? All right. You do it, and I'm on it, man. Oh, I gotta hurry up for my Disney classic. I think it's a Lion King moment. That's a good one. Bye, guys. Have a good day. Thank you, too. But technically, Disney is High School Musical, too, isn't it?
Uh-huh. Yes.
We have an enthusiastic High School Musical. Yes, ma'am. What up? You can drop next Friday. Next Friday? Oh, Little Mermaid. Okay. What's up?
That I'm missing, like, should I don't know which ones I'm missing.
Just do one from that week and get it done.
Okay. So should I get, like, experience?
Yes. You need to get done. It needs to be done by 3:25 today, girl.
Maybe he's right. Perfect. Maybe there is Disney something the matter with me. I just don't see how a world that makes such wonderful things could be bad. Look at this stuff. Isn't it neat? Wouldn't you think my collection's complete? Wouldn't you think I'm the girl who has everything? Look at this trove, treasures untold. How many wonders can one cavern hold? Looking around here, you think, sure, she's got everything. I've got gadgets and gizmos aplenty. I got who's it's and what's it's galore. You want thingamabobs? I got 20. But who cares? No big deal. I want more. I want to be where the people are. I want to see them dancing. walking around on those, what do you call them? Oh, feet. Flipping your fins, you don't get too far. Legs are required for jumping, dancing, strolling around down a, what's that word again? Street. Up where they walk, up where they run, up where they stay all day in the sun, wandering free. Wish I could be part of that world. What would I give if I could live out of these waters? What would I pay to spend a day warm on the sand? That you're on land, they understand that they don't reprimand their daughters. Bright young women, sick of swimming, ready to stand. Ready to know what the people know. Ask them my questions and get some answers. What's a fire and why does it, what's the word? Learn. When's it my turn? Would my love love to explode and shore up above?
First spirit, we did Moana, so it's been a big day.
I be part of that
last night. I got home at like 1:30 this morning,
but I made a lot of money. A lot of money. A lot.
Did I tell you? It was a lot of money. And so yes, now I'm sick and I still have to work tomorrow, but that's fine because I made a lot of money. Are we ready? Not already ready. So does that mean we're ready? Hello? Oh, we're in second period. That's, we're dying. I'm dying.